Now we'll study and analyze longitudinal chromatic aberration in a lens. If we consider a convex lens on which a white light is incident onto it, we know well that in case of white light, the focal point will be spreaded between violet and red colored focus, and violet focus will be closer and red focus will be farther away, because the refractive index for violet color is more and for red color is less. Now, this is the region in which the focal point is spreaded. It is because of the variation in wavelength and refractive index of the material of lens. Now, if this is the focal length for violet color and this is the focal length for red color, then the spread will be written as D, and this spread can be written as FR minus FV. This separation or spread of the focal point we call longitudinal chromatic aberration by the lens. This we can also mathematically calculate if mu V and mu R as well as mu Y are the refractive index of lens material for violet, red and yellow light. This implies here we can write by lens maker's formula, the focal length for red light will be mu R minus 1. And if it is considered to be a biconvex lens, we can write 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. And if it is considered to be an equiconvex lens, it can be written as 2 by R, as the signs of the two radii are different. But in general, we are taking R1 and R2. And here 1 by focal length for violet light, we can write mu V minus 1, 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. And simultaneously, we can write focal length for yellow light, that is for mean focal length. This is mu y minus 1 multiplied by 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. Now, in this situation, if we take the difference of these focal lengths, 1 by focal length of violet minus 1 by focal length of red, then you can see we are getting this mu v minus mu r multiplied by 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. I am using these two equations and we are subtracting the two. On simplifying this, we are getting FR minus FV divided by FV FR is equals to this. We can write as mu V minus mu R, and this right hand side we can multiply it by the term mu Y minus 1 by mu Y minus 1. So this will give us mu V minus mu R by mu Y minus 1 multiplied by mu y minus 1 multiplied by 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. And you can see this is the dispersive power of the material, and this term is the reciprocal of the focal length for yellow light. And here we can also write, we can also use the product of FV and FR is approximately FY square. So, in this situation, as Fy is the mean focal length, so in this situation, if we substitute the values, this will give us Fr minus Fv is equal to, so this will be Fy square and this 1 by Fy and this omega. So, this will give us omega multiplied by Fy. This is the only approximation we are taking over here. And this giving us the value of a longitudinal chromatic aberration in lens, which is equal to the product of dispersive power multiplied by the mean focal length of the lens for the mean light or the yellow light in case of white light incidence.